Malinga again. Tracks it through, so Taylor gets on strike. Local crowd, this is his home venue. He plays for the Stags. A Wairarapa boy from Masterton, and educated at Masterton College, then pinched off them by Palmerston North Boys High because they recognised the talent. Prodigious striker of a hockey ball as well, has chosen to go the cricket route. He's on 99. It's 237 for 5 and the field closing in. They're not going to make it easy for him. JL Warden is going to stretch it out as long as he possibly can. The crowd are onto it. The surf lifesavers are out in force. Don't swim between these flags. Inside the circle. Pressure on. Taylor pushes and goes. It's in the gap. He's got it. He's got his first. And on the level of composure we've seen today, it will not be his last.
What a moment for the young man. He's a player with a maturity that is above his age. It's been the way he's come in. He got himself established. He got a strike rate going. He got the innings moving again after the wicket. And he just kept it going. He's punched it straight down the ground. It's been a very, very good 100. It's been a sensible 100. And he's there. Now he needs to cut loose.
And he'll try. He's Malinga. Oh, cracking shot. Can't get it through. Taylor can't get it. He gets back and they get the overthrow. Now you can expect some helter-skelter cricket. No backing up for Sri Lanka. A mistake.
Everyone's got to be on the ball. It was a good shot. It was a shot that deserved runs. Just missed the Yorker lead that Hamish Marshall was up to it. They picked the fieldsman out. The throw was on. He had to throw it, but there was no backing. Sloppy cricket.
240 for 5. 5.5 overs to go. What a day. What a day in the sun. Oh, one of CD's favourite. Brilliantly played. It's got away from Sangakkara. He ramped it in the modern term.
It's all warming up. Hamish Marshall practicing the stroke, obviously not the ball at that pace, just looking to run it as if he was giving slip catching practice because he knew he might need it later on in the day. This is Ross Taylor's innings. Just pushed it around early on and then he got things going against Shaminda Vass. That went for 6. It's just a flick. That was mistimed. If it had been, it would have gone a mile, but it still went for 4. Very strong with his hands from the onside. Look at that. He got New Zealand scoring again against Dilshan. And then he capped it off. The singles pretty much all around the ground. Fours all around the ground. Very strong down the ground and square on the leg side and on the offside. Flicking away on the onside. That 6 there was almost a leg glance. It was a leg glance. It went the whole way and another one over the top of square leg, but he's got an all-round game, a good hit on his shoulders. So many people talking about get Ross Taylor in there. They'll be nodding their approval right now.
And now the more important part of the equation, the team equation, 5 overs. It's 245 for 5, a chance to get through to 280, 290 maybe. Beautifully played, that's a boundary. Gee, that's a great shot, you know. You need a quick eye and some very quick reflexes to play a square drive on the charge.
It was well controlled. He was originally looking to give himself width to play off the front foot down the ground. Bowler tried to counter, but if you do go short, it opens up the ground 360 degrees. Marshall just picked a spot.
Well, Fernando has played 100 one-day internationals. You'd think he would have the nous to sort this out lengthwise, and at the moment he's had a bit of a nightmare here at McLean Park. Half volley, chipped in the gap, is it? Yeah, it will be. So now what will Taylor's attitude be? You kind of think he's thinking in big numbers now, fours and sixes, and the bailout option will be the single.
Not the smallest ground here, it's not a huge ground, McLean Park and Napier, but if that man gets hold of them now, it'll be way too small.
And Ando has to get it right. Bang! Boy! Smacked it! Way over the top, and he's just cramped up a wee bit. Oh, talk us through this, Mark Richardson. This is your show. Except you hit it for Gnome.
What, the six? Or no, the cramp?
No, the cramp. Your cramp, the shots go for, what, dots? Come on. This is your show, pal.
Yep, that's right. Missed his length, just swung through. Just swung, and all he had to do was pick it up. Told you the ground would be too small. I think that could have gone right out of it. And then bang! You feel like someone shot you in the hamstring.
Well, at least he didn't scream and yell and make a real pansy of himself like you did.
Just wait till he's had four of them in a row.
Look, you got cramp pushing forward. For none. Crunch down the ground. Fielder in play. Ross Taylor is just going to celebrate here for a while if he can, if he can hold his poise. So 12 off four balls. And New Zealand have rocketed up now to 257.
Missed a few opportunities around the late 30, early 40th overs, but they're picking it up now.
Straight up. Keeper should have the Sangakkara, and he does. So Hamish Marshall sacrifices. Gee, that went high as well.
It's a straight drive, attempted straight drive that he's hit behind himself. Quite amazing. It was a good, clever piece of bowling. Fernando's got this right. He's used a split finger, and because of that, Marshall just got through it way too soon, and all he could do is hit it straight up behind him, straight over his head. The man with the gloves takes it.
It's a new meaning to court behind, doesn't it? It's 257 for six. Jimmy Franklin's been in pretty good batting form, and a strike rate of 61, so he led the score at least that rate. He's only averages 11.76, but doesn't get that many opportunities, and neither he should too at number 8 or 9. But last ball of Fernando's over. He's picked up Hamish Marshall, so he could end on a better note. Just doesn't carry through to Sangakkara, bottom edge. Taylor's hobbling. He's got problems. Four overs to go, 257 for six. So now Franklin has to try and perhaps give the Taylor strike to Taylor, but Taylor's a bit incapacitated. Bang! Pinpoint accuracy. Outstanding bowling.
A great comeback this by Malingra. He had his troubles early on. Nathan Astle severe and with the new ball, but this time he's found that Yorker length. The length we saw in the test matches and some reverse swing, and it's the swing that's done James Franklin. Played the wrong line, just missed it. And he's on his way for two. It's 262 for seven.
Come on down, Andre Adams. It's 262 for seven. The last ball of the 47th over. And could you even contemplate when Astle got out in the 29th that to be two down New Zealand, that they could run the risk of being bowled out? That's the comeback that Sri Lanka have put on them here. Malinga again. Oh. Terrific over that, it really was. To Taylor. He can't go anywhere, right? Taylor is on his haunches.
Look at that length. Look at that length. He's backed off to, I don't think that's cramped there, to try to give himself some room. And Vasa's just bowled the perfect length and he couldn't reach it.